Sheep are highly effective pasture managers. A single flock of sheep will quickly devour any tall pasture grasses and herbs in their path, leaving piles of nutrient-rich poop that increase the fertility of the soil. Our challenge is to harness this power to build soil, improve pasture health, and raise happy sheep in an ethical and sustainable way. In this video, we'll dive into rotational grazing, a system where sheep are moved frequently throughout different areas of the farm every few days. This system helps to avoid overgrazing, promotes pasture regeneration, and benefits the land and long-term health of our farm. The system is fairly simple. The sheep are moved using portable electric fencing and shelters. Everything can be easily moved and set up by one person, though many hands make light work. The first step is to mow any tall grass or vegetation around the perimeter of the new paddock, which will help to keep the fence electrified. We then set up the new perimeter, adjacent to the previous one, and simply let the sheep into their new paddock. As the sheep munch on fresh grass, we move their shelter and water troughs as well. This process is repeated every 1 to 3 days. The short but intense period of grazing and pooping promotes the health and productivity of the pasture. It controls plant height, preventing certain species from becoming too dominant. The manure that the sheep leave behind replenishes the soil with nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Once the sheep move, the previously grazed area is allowed to rest and recover. During this recovery phase, the pasture begins to regrow, and the roots of the plants tap deeper into the soil. Their strong root systems are able to capture more sunlight through photosynthesis, leading to faster regrowth and higher quality forage. But it's not just the pasture and soil that benefit from this system. It's the sheep, too. The sheep are eager to move to a new area. With frequent moves to fresh pasture, they get access to the freshest and most nutritious forage. Sheep are ruminants, meaning they have a specialized digestive system with 4 stomach compartments that allow them to break down tough plant material like grasses, legumes, and herbs. The key part of this process happens in the rumen, the first and largest stomach compartment, where fermentation occurs. When the sheep consume plant material, it enters the rumen, where billions of microbes, such as bacteria, protozoa, and fungi, begin to break down the plant fibers. These microbes ferment the cellulose in the plants, producing volatile fatty acids and providing energy for the sheep. In a sense, the sheep are converting sunlight into their own bodies. The plants they graze absorb sunlight through photosynthesis, converting it into chemical energy stored in sugars and carbohydrates. When the sheep eat the plants, they are tapping into this stored solar energy. The sheep break down plant materials into usable proteins and energy, which are then incorporated into their own tissues. Energy from the sun is passed through the system, transforming into protein and other nutrients that sustain not only the sheep, but also the farmers and their communities. This system also plays a significant role in carbon sequestration by enhancing the soil's ability to store carbon. When the sheep graze, they consume plants that have absorbed carbon from the atmosphere through photosynthesis. This carbon is incorporated into their manure as organic compounds that build soil structure and support carbon storage. When the plants regrow, they continue to capture CO2 and convert it into carbohydrates, which are stored in their roots. These carbon-rich roots contribute to soil organic matter, further enriching the soil and creating a long-term carbon reservoir. Over time, the soil's capacity to store carbon increases, transforming the land into a carbon sink. Well-managed pastures can actually sequester more carbon than is released, reducing atmospheric CO2 and mitigating anthropogenic climate change, Rotational grazing is a system that connects us to our food and the land. It engages us with a farm ecosystem, a living agroecosystem. Farmers become stewards of the land, rather than just producers. This interaction fosters a genuine connection with the land, forming culture and a strong land ethic rooted in the idea that humans are a part of the natural world. Adopting this mindset is not only beneficial for our own health and well-being, it is essential for the survival of future generations. As our understanding evolves, we adapt our practices and create more sustainable and ethical land use systems. We will continue to document this work and show how people and farmers are shifting their practices and mindsets to manage the land in a better way. In the meantime, I would love to hear your thoughts on this subject. Have you tried rotational grazing before? What are some ways we can manage our grazing to keep the land healthy? If you have any ideas or suggestions, let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching. Have a good one.